said, and special use. So this is a hydration product in a, it is Himalayan sea salt. And gives you these killer pumps with the...
Awesome flavor, that one.
Dude, this is off the fucking charts. Okay, so this, I don't even know if the people can see this label. Screenshot that, guys. Okay. I took two scoops. So this is called Amplify.
Peach mango.
Okay. So you have something for a non-stem pre-workout. Because it is, what time right now?
11.
It's 11 o'clock at night.
Yeah.
And I've been up since 6 because I started with calls at 6 o'clock. So, and I don't take naps. So we're not living life over here. Like, who takes naps all day? Who can we say?
Bodybuilders. Well, you're not a full-time bodybuilder anymore.
You're a full-time bodybuilder more than me, bro.
How can you say that? You know everything that I do in the day, too.
Bro, you drive to Venice every day.
Yeah, exactly. So that's not time spent cooking or sleeping or training. Exactly. I do it for work, too. I do it for the channel. Multitasking. Good, huh? I love that flavor.
This is strong right now. Oh? Because I didn't mix it.
Yeah, exactly. Awesome, awesome. Yum.
Yum, yum.
Do you know which one you're going to put on tonight?
I have an idea.
You have an idea?
Isn't it kind of nice to have your own shoes? Like, you notice, you know, I have like, I don't even know how many shoes I have. You see my shoe closet. I have shit I've never even taken out of boxes for, like several. You know, my guy sent me today, look, he texts me. I'm going to show you guys this. This is like real life shit, you know? So he hit me today, and he says, so he goes like this, he goes, okay, want? I said, can I steal it? He said, $160. I said, it's a good leather, yes. What will they be worth? He says, not more than what's paid for. Huh. I said, I haven't got any of the new, I haven't even worn any of the new ones yet. He said, no need for new pairs then. So he constantly sends me shoes to get.
Yeah.
Because, you know, I love the Jordan 1s, bro. They're like my favorite shoes. If you notice, when I go to a lot of these trade events, I wear them,
mm-hmm.
you know, to stand at the shows. But, you know, the Atomics, if you guys haven't worn Atomics, make sure you guys at least try a pair out. You know, we'll have a booth at the Arnold.
Yeah, we'll be there.
And if you come by, you know, we're giving a discount at the Arnold. But listen, guys, if you guys are shopping for a pair of Atomic shoes, Atomics.com, use the code J25. Put that on the screen.
Yeah.
J25, and you'll save 25% off, okay? So get on there now in order, and then bring them to the Arnold, and I'll sign them even. But if you want to wait at the Arnold and you want to buy a pair, and I'm there actually signing shoes.
And taking pictures.
Make sure you come by.
Different car today.
Well, this is my car, but...
But you never drive it. All right.
So, I can't forget the car. I gotta get the car. All right, so I mentioned it's 11:15 at night. Remember when I used to train like in the middle of the night?
Yeah.
Do you know why I did that?
Because nobody else would do it.
That's why. That was the only reason why. But, you know, the worst day is leg day, right? Everyone dreads leg day. It's my favorite day of the week, but I dread it too because it's always the hardest day. But I'm going to do legs at 11:15 at night.
You know who I used to feel bad for?
Who?
Is Mitz. When he was shooting you. Because you would drag him out of bed in the middle of the night at, you know, 1 o'clock.
You never got to see him at the Fit Expo, huh?
No. You saw him?
Yeah, he came over to my booth.
Oh, really?
Yeah, he shouted at me.
Oh, man, I miss Mitz.
I told him we were just talking about him.
What did he say?
He's like, man, you know, it seems like... He told me it doesn't seem like anything changed since he left.
Really?
Yeah.
I miss him.
He's a good dude.
He was a good guy. He did all your videos.
So he shot all the Battle for the Olympias and...
All your videos.
Ronnie Coleman videos and...
I mean, you would do a video with him like every year, huh?
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, every year for every show I did one.
Wow. Yeah, he was great.
All the back doors open, that's why.
Oh, I didn't do it.
No.
All right. Get the whole gym to ourselves.
Here we are.
All right.
Thank you. they go crazy. Okay, well, maybe just a little crazy. Cause I made them crazy about that lady.
That was a quick one.
Yeah, but we got the job done, right? That's the main thing.
40 minutes, boom.
So you guys that other gym training 3 hours, not really necessary. A lot of short rest times though, right?
Yeah, 30 seconds.
Training by myself is always, you know, a little easier. And obviously with legs, I'm not trying to go, I'm not trying to absolutely destroy my legs at this point. I like fitting into clothes, actually.
They're still big, dude, come on.
I know, but nothing like they used to be. That's the main thing. Is we all slowly gonna come down. You know how it goes. Right?
I don't know. I don't think your downsizing plan is working too well.
You don't think so, huh?
Everybody keeps saying, he's not downsizing. Come on, man. They say you look fuller and leaner than you were a few weeks ago. They're paying attention. That's the problem. By shooting so often, people actually notice all that stuff.
I think,
dude.
I think I'm paying attention to the diet, and I can't preach that enough.
Yeah.
You know how crucial the diet is.
Well, when you're home and you actually can train and eat, you gain 10 pounds in a week.
Yeah, and I went over my schedule today, and right now, April's my only crazy, crazy month. The rest is just you know, mandatory stuff, but...
Yeah.
I'm really, really trying to stay home and film more content because I think I'm getting a lot of great feedback from the constant content we're putting out.
Doesn't this feel like 2013 to you a little bit?
Oh, so I'm not training for a contest.
I know, but you know, me coming here to Vegas and just
yeah,
like...
It's awesome.
It's awesome.
I get to hang out more, but...
I know, it's great.
You know, it's...
People love it. Still.
It's part of the process, man. Like, I'm still fighting. Like, what excites me every day, right? Business excites me. Trips excite me.
Yeah.
You know, being with family, friends. You know, but training is still a huge part of my life. It's never going to change.
Yeah.
And I love that about, you know, this lifestyle. And it can be a very healthy one. So I know there's a lot of negative aspects out there. We were just talking about that a little bit while we were training. But,
yeah.
Like, if you do it the right way, it's very safe. And... You know, people sit there and think that because I was an Olympian and a top one that, you know, it took an abundance of drugs to be who I was. And, you know, although, you know, you can't steer away from, you know, certain aspects of bodybuilding, it takes so much more than just someone that, you know, takes whatever, this and that, or... You know, eats at certain times. It's the consistency of the eating and the training that fuels the whole process. And if you, I never took time off. Like,
yeah,
I see these guys nowadays and they're like, oh, I'm taking time off. Like, it's great to let your body rest if you have injuries or yeah. You're feeling pain, but I've never been in pain or never had problems. The only time I ever took off for 1 week really was when I tore my bicep. I couldn't train legs for. I mean, couldn't train my upper body for like 4 weeks. Other, you know, I had to train legs. So, you know, I remember being back in the gym training legs within a week. And I just trained legs around the shoulder and bicep injury.
Was it hard not to train the upper body?
Fuck, I wanted to train so bad. Because remember, I still had the mindset to compete then. At least now I don't have the mindset to really compete.
Yeah,
so,
yeah.
For me, it's like, I think back, but... You know, I was watching a documentary on Mike Tyson on Joe Rogan podcast, actually, and he said something that was very, very relative to what I feel. And he's like, I don't even remember how I trained, because they mentioned, you know, he's doing this Tyson Ranch, which is like a getaway, like, cannabis place or something, like a retreat.
Mm.
And Joe's like, man, you can teach these young kids maybe how to box a little bit. And he, like, kind of joked about it. He's like, man, I wouldn't even know how to go back to living that kind of lifestyle. He said, when I was done, I was done. I was checked out. But it's like a whole nother life. That's how I feel about bodybuilding almost. Like,
wow.
You know, I can't imagine being in that zone to cut everything else out. Because I have so many good things going on now that are more relative to my life than just training for a Mr. Olympia title. So... I respect those guys with that tunnel vision because you really have to have that in order to be successful and the level that these guys compete at and be their best on stage. So, you know, my hat goes off to those guys. It's just awesome. And I can't wait to go to the Arnold and watch these guys stay tuned for my predictions on the Arnold. I hate predictions, but I'll predict who I feel are top runners for that show and who are the sleepers, because I do have a couple of that.
It's coming.
Yeah, it's coming, so stay tuned, guys.
Awesome.
What? Stuff people can't buy yet.
This is my final of the protein that I'm having. This is an isolate protein, so.
Do you know what you're gonna call it yet, or?
Secret.
Oh. Okay.
Remember when we were calling the pre-workout Bomb Pop?
Yeah.
We couldn't call it
that. I know.
I don't want to take the chance.
Yeah.
So.
To read you all those labels.
You gonna try the chocolate tomorrow, right?
I mean, I tried it tonight.
Oh, you are?
I need some protein, yeah.
How much do you have?
Huh?
How many grams?
I don't know. I think one pack. What is that?
25 grams.
Okay.
It's enough. You ate a lot tonight.
I'll mix it with something else. Boom. That's a wrap.
Stay huge.